the issue of trafficking in human beings is a problem that in the current period can only be tackled in a coordinated manner when we are speaking about a European level. Just like the UN describes it, trafficking is a form of slavery, and all the countries around the globe are touched by it in one form or another. Moreover, it has several dimensions and facets that are all unfortunately manifested across the member states in Europe, such as trafficking for purposes such as sexual exploitation, labor exploitation, domestic servitude, begging, and removal of organs, which is sadly said, we can find it among children mostly. We are here today to discuss the existing situation in the European Union and try to find out solutions and ways of addressing this matter in a coordinated manner, because we need a coordinated manner in this issue. In a European Union without border controls and frontiers, where everybody is free to move everywhere within the Europe, trafficking in human beings is also a cross-border issue that requires a fair amount of coordination from all authorities, from all the countries. I believe that especially in this case, we need a strategic approach in order to be able to fight this problem correctly and, let's say, efficiently. I would just like to give you some information on who are the victims that are most suffering from trafficking in Europe. And here we come to the conclusions that women are involved 77% of trafficking cases, with sexual exploitation with a factor of 87% out of this 77. Forced labor is also a motive behind trafficking. According to the International Labour Organization, there are globally at least 2.45 million people in forced labour as a result of trafficking in person, which is a very high amount. Most people are trafficked into forced labour for commercial sexual exploitation, that it's about 43%, or various other reasons, 25%. The remainder, 32%, are victims of trafficking for economic exploitation. Anyway, women and girls represent 56% of victims, and men and boys, 44%. As regards forced commercial sexual exploitation, an overwhelming majority of 98% is representing by women and girls. This is enough to show us that women and children have the highest risk. Especially in the case of children, reports and studies on concrete situations, like the report of anti-trafficking monitoring group done in the UK, show that there are many situations where the victims do not come forward because they are fearful that their immigration status will be brought to the attention of the national authorities, and that's why they are feared to come and reclaim the trafficking. In the same manner, the European Agency for Fundamental Rights report on child trafficking in the EU talks about children that disappear from immigration shelters and are not accounted for by national authorities. There are no statistics being done at this level, and children that are suspected of being the victims of human trafficking can still be detained on immigration offences according to the national legislation in the member states of the EU. More needs to be done in this respect, and apart from the EU provisions that can be established, the national authorities must also come forward, and they have to have the will and interest to collaborate with each other. I am certain that through this seminar we will be able at least to shed some light on the nature of this issue, and that we will also try to identify maybe some policy aspects that can be implemented not only at the European level, but possibly and necessary, I would say, at the national level in order to to solve the problems. So I would like to then to welcome you again to this seminar and to hope that we will really find some solutions maybe. And thank again to the speakers and to my colleagues. And I would also like to say you that I will apologize, but at a certain moment I would need to leave the room for another meeting. So thank you very much.